So we've seen that phase transitions give rise to power laws. At the critical point, at the point where the system goes from one phase to another, where the transition occurs, many quantities of interest are distributed according to a power law. And that's not the case on either side of that transition. So power laws and phase transitions are closely linked. The question then is, what fraction of the power laws that we observe more generally in the study of complex systems can be said to be due to a phase transition-like behavior of some sort? So that's a question that I want to address from a number of different angles in this video. And I should mention that much more than some of the other videos, I'll be giving some opinions and less an accounting of mathematical or empirical facts. I think the position that I'm going to carve out is pretty much a standard one within the study of complex systems, but there's certainly some room for disagreement. So, what fraction of the power law of the power laws that we observe in complex systems arise from phase transitions? So I think the answer is almost none. That phase transitions likely are not an explanation for the vast majority of the power laws we see in complex systems. So why do I say that? Well, a phase transition is a very unusual state of affairs. The phase transition, it's a critical point, a critical temperature, a critical transition probability, only one out of a whole number of different things. So it's very unlikely that we would sort of encounter that by chance. Here in the physical world, things are very rarely poised right at the critical point, right between liquid and solid, or magnet and non-magnet. Things tend to be solid or liquid or gas, and not poised right at that point in between the two. So because phase transitions by definition occur at a very narrow, at a very particular point, very particular set of parameters, it seems unlikely that that could be a generic explanation for power laws that we see quite commonly throughout a whole range of social and biological and technological phenomena. But phase transitions and power laws have often been closely linked, more so in the past, less so these days. And I want to offer some thoughts on why that may be. I think a lot of it has to do with the culture and habits of mind of physicists. So let me explain what I mean by this. So within physics, and I say this as a physicist, the theory of phase transitions, also known as the theory of critical phenomena, is a fantastic theory. It has everything that a physicist would get excited about. It explains a broad range of phenomena in fairly simple terms, right? So this is the idea of universality, that many different transitions, even in systems that seem very different, are characterized by the same exponents. So it collects a lot of phenomena together into a similar quantitative framework. There's some non-trivial mathematics behind it, the renormalization group explaining why some of this is so. So it's a sort of thing that a physicist, most physicists, just love. It's a great theory. It deservedly got a lot of attention in, I guess, the 70s and the 80s, I would say. So the theory of critical phenomena is a significant accomplishment within the study of physics, both theoretical and experimental. So a lot of the claims that linked power laws in other areas and complex systems with phase transitions were originated by physicists who were accustomed to associating power laws and phase transitions. And again, phase transitions are seen as a very interesting thing in physics. It's an unusual state of affairs, difficult to explain, but then can be understood with some mathematics. So there's an interest, sort of fascination, one's drawn towards phase transitions, and phase transitions give rise to power laws, and so in the mind of many physicists, the two are closely linked. And of course, that's right. It is indeed the case that power laws arise from phase transitions. But as we've seen in this unit, power laws also arise from many, many other types of situations that have nothing to do with a phase transition. And this is something that many physicists, I think, weren't aware of. And so when they saw power law behavior, they were quick to say, oh, this must indicate some sort of a phase transition, that the system is poised between two different states, a state of order and disorder. So I think physicists first tended to see be drawn towards power laws in the first place, because power laws are associated with phase transitions, which are interesting. And then seeing power laws immediately associated them with phase transitions and critical phenomena. There's one other reason having to do with the culture of physicists that maybe suggests why there was a little bit of hype, or maybe some alleged power laws that turned out upon re-examination to not be that well described by a power law. And that is that physicists tend to not learn much statistics. It's rarely a degree requirement for physicists. My background is in statistical physics, but I was never required to take a statistics class. And insofar as we do learn things like statistics, it's more about error propagation in experiments and less about testing hypotheses and model verification. So those are skills that are taught more often in the sciences, I think, in biology and economics, and actually less in physics. And of course, it's taught in statistics all the time. So all that is to say is that physicists didn't necessarily know about some of the more advanced or modern data analysis techniques that I described in Unit 5, leading some to claim that power laws were present in light of maybe not such convincing evidence. So, to sum up, phase transitions most definitely do give rise to power laws. Of that, there's no dispute. But there are many other mechanisms that give rise to power laws as well. So I think that the physicists' understandable fascination with phase transitions and power laws has sometimes maybe extended a little bit too far into the field of complex systems. That phase transitions are beautiful physics and a really impressive theory, but maybe not always so useful in the study of complex systems.